Hello everybody. Welcome to my new video. In this video I will talk about robotic process automation lifecycle and explain it in details. Let's go. Robotic process automation consists of five main phases. These are, discovery, create PDD or process design document, implementation of the bot, testing like user acceptance test, and the last one is go live. First we will talk about the discovery phase. A department has a process that should be implemented as a bot. Here the department will contact the business analyst and discuss the process with him in detail. The department must explain the process in detail, and answer any questions from the business analyst about the process. The department should also answer the following questions: what is the estimated volume of items to be processed per month? What is the average processing time per item for an employee? Are process changes expected across the year? If so, what change would occur? Can an increase in the volume of items to be processed be expected in the course of the year? And the other topics are discussed, such as, what input does the process have? What applications does the process work with? How stable are these systems? And whether there are test and prod systems? After the process has been explained in details, the business analyst can decide whether the process can be automated or not. If the process can be automated, we can move on to the next phase, create PDD. PDD stands for Process Design Document or Process Definition Document. A process design document is a document that captures the flow of a business process to be developed within RPA. It typically contains the process flow and sequence of steps for the current manual, as is, process, as well as the automated, to be, process, and the various exceptions, conditions and rules of the business process to be automated. Normally authored by a business analyst, the PDD is the most common mechanism used in RPA implementations to communicate business processes to be automated and facilitate development. Here is an example for a PDD for a process, where the employee has to read an Excel file and write the data in SAP system for each row from this Excel file. We can see all information about the process in this document, like input, output, applications, high-level steps and the exceptions. After the PDD has been created, we can move on to the next phase, implementation. The main person in this phase is the developer. He implements the bot in an automation tool using the PDD. If there are any questions or ambiguities in the PDD, the developer contacts the business analyst. If the business analyst cannot answer the questions, she or he contacts the department and clarifies the open questions. There are different automation tools that can be used to implement a bot, such as UiPath, blueprism, WorkFusion, Microsoft Power Automate, Automation Anywhere, Jidoka, KRYON Systems, KOFAX, and many other tools. Here is an example of a process implemented in blueprism. You can see how the process logic is implemented, with many decisions, stages, pages, etc. This is ultimately our bot code. Testing phase takes place after implementation. Two tests should be carried out here. First UAT, user acceptance test, and then PRT, productive run test. Testing is intended for the department to check that the bot is delivering correct results before the bot goes live. For testing, the department supplies some test cases for the developer so that the developer can process these test cases with the implemented bot. These test cases must cover all scenarios so that the bot does not cause any problems later in the live operation. This test checks all possible scenarios, whether it is a happy path or a business exception. After the UAT has been carried out, the department receives the results. They check the results to see whether they have performed as expected or whether there are any errors. If everything is correct, the bot will be deployed on the productive machine. I forgot to mention that the UAT is done on a test machine, and also with a test system if there is one. If the test is unsuccessful, the developer will fix the bot and the UAT will take place again. We assume the UAT was successful and the bot is deployed on the productive machine. The PRT should now be carried out. PRT is exactly like UAT, but on the productive machine and with the productive system. The only difference here is that the PRT is not performed manually from the studio, but from the scheduler. If the PRT is unsuccessful, we will go back to UAT. If it is successful, then move on to the next phase. After intensive testing, the bot is now ready for go live. It can now be scheduled, as requested by the department. Shortly after going live, the developer should always monitor the bot and check whether there are any problems, until the bot shows that it is stable. The bot will be then monitored normally, like any other bot in the live operation. So we are done with the RPA lifecycle. I hope you can take something out of this video. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to write them in the comments.